In the last learning module, we talked about double integrals over rectangles and how you could write those as iterated integrals. Now we're going to talk about double integrals over more general regions. So let's suppose we've got a region like this, and we want to figure out how to take the integral over it. Now the trouble is, our definitions were for integrals over rectangles. So the way that we handle this is we just put a rectangle around it. So if you want to integrate a function f of x on a region R, you find a bigger region R twiddle, a rectangle, and we're going to do an integral over here. Of course, we don't actually want to integrate a non-trivial function over here. We want to integrate 0 for this outer region. We want to integrate the function in the inner region. So we define a new function, f twiddle, which is f on the inner region and 0 on the outer region. And we define the integral of f over the general region as the integral over r twiddle of f twiddle. That's the way you define double integrals over general regions in general. So let's go back and say, how do we go about integrating something over a rectangle? Well, our rule was that we had to chop the rectangle into boxes. And then we had to take the value of the function in each box and multiply it by the area of the box and add up the boxes and take a limit. Now, how much is this box going to contribute? Well, f twiddle is 0 over here, so it's not going to contribute anything. All of the boxes that are outside of R contribute exactly 0 because our function f twiddle is 0 there. So really, they may as well not be there. The big region R twiddle is needed in order to make a precise definition, but for our purposes, it may as well not be there. All you really have is the region R and the boxes. So, and in the region R, what's the function that we're trying to add up? We're trying to add up the function f of x. So the way that you get an integral over a general region, what an integral means is just like the integral of a rectangle, the idea is you chop the region into little boxes, and then for each box, you take the value of the function in that box times the area of the box, you add them all together, and then you take a limit as you chop things into smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller boxes. So that is the definition of an integral over a general region. Now the trouble is, that doesn't really tell you how to compute an integral, and that's a matter of arranging the boxes. So there are two types of regions that we look at. One is a type 1 region. A type 1 region is a region that's bounded on the left by the line x equals a, on the right by x equals b, and then by some curve up here and some curve down here. This curve is y is a function of x, let's call it h of x. And the lower curve is y is some other function of x, let's call it g of x. And the way that we understand this is really much the same as the way that we did double integrals over rectangles. We look at our boxes and we try to figure out what is the contribution of each column. We know how to do this. We did this when we were having rectangles. We want to figure out the contribution of this column. What we have to do is add up all the boxes with the same value of x. And adding up those boxes and taking a limit is really integrating in the y direction. And we integrate from this lower value to this upper value. So the contribution of a single box is just the value times the area. The contribution of the column is what we're going to figure out first. And then we're going to add all the columns together. Now, if you have a type 2 region, a type 2 region is the same thing in reverse. You're bounded by a big value of y, a little value of y, and in between, You chop things into boxes. And you add up the boxes sideways. And you go from the first value of the smallest value of x to the biggest value of x for each value of y. And that gives you the contribution of the row. And then you add the rows together. So let's see what that's like in terms of formulas. So, again, for type 1 regions, we organize things into boxes. We think in terms of columns, and then each column has a bunch of little pieces. And if you want to understand what is going on for the whole column, well, one box gives you the value of the function times delta x times delta y. The whole column, you have to integrate that with respect to y. And then you have to add up the columns. And the columns run from x equals a all the way to x equals b. And so the total, the double integral over a type 1 region, is first you do an integral dy from g of x to h of x. And then you do an integral dx from a to b. Now there's an important thing to notice here. The limits of y are functions of x. That's because down here, where you start is different for different values of x, and where you end is different for different values of x. So the limits of y are functions of x. The limits on x are numbers, because these aren't counting boxes, these are counting columns. The leftmost column is at x equals a. The rightmost column is at x equals b. So you're adding up all of the columns is integrating from a to b. In the next video, we'll do a couple of examples of type 1 regions and of type 2 regions.